Hi, good morning. No, I didn't bring my own cushion to sit on this chair. I'm here with a brief announcement in regards to renovation. As you know, we have refurbished, we have recovered all of the cushions in the church. We have over 90 pieces of red velvet fabric. Before I throw it away, I'm offering it if anybody would like to have some red velvet fabric for any reason. It may have, it's got spots on it from candle wax, but we've got four or five large bags of pieces of fabric. They're about 3 to 4 yards long, about 2 feet wide. Let me know. We also unearthed several boxes of candles, white and red 12-inch tapers. Please do not go and buy candles. See me if you can use any 12-inch white or red candles. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. And now to continue our announcements, let us remember in our prayers, if you can see the names at the back of the program, please let us continue to speak healing into the lives of all of those persons who are in need of healing at this time. And particularly, let us remember those who have had recent surgeries. Mrs. Linda Pinder, Mrs. Elizabeth Howard, Mrs. Kathleen Albury, and Catherine Johnson. Lord, hear our prayer, and let our cry come unto thee for their healing. And as we continue with the announcements, anyone interested in providing flowers for the upcoming months for the altar, please kindly contact Ann Lever, or anyone from the decorating team. Also, a reminder to you that the church secretary's position is still open, so if you're interested, please call the number there at the church office. And a special message to all of the Ebenezer men. And it says here, hi guys, all right? The Ebenezer men will meet for Father's Day choir rehearsals on Wednesday, June 7th, the following Monday, June 12th, and then again on Wednesday, June 14th at 7 p.m. So we're looking forward to all of the men participating. We always have such a wonderful choir on Father's Day. And just a quick reminder to you, the BCMC 30th anniversary, just a quick look, there's a calendar, anniversary booklets available for sale in the office. If you have any questions, please call the office. And now for birthday greetings. Diana Malone, who celebrates today, that's the 29th. Happy birthday, Diana. Deborah Bethel on the 3rd. Elois Johnson, also on the 3rd, and also on May 31st, Dariano Stubbs. And so let us sing a happy birthday to all of those persons who have birthdays in the upcoming week. Happy birthday to you. Our liturgical dance group, a selection they didn't know. And they're wearing their wonderful red for Pentecost, the fire of the Holy Spirit.
For the sins of the world, he bowed his head and he died.
Ooh,
yeah.
Hung his head
and he died. Oh, oh, can't you see
my Jesus?
Oh, the blood.
Bowed his head.
Oh, the blood.
To our young people for telling the story in dance. He rose, he arose, he ascended. Yes, last week and today, the Holy Spirit is with us on this Pentecost Sunday. And now, our Pentecostal candle will be lit. Please let us pray. Let us bow our heads and pray. Holy Spirit, come. You are welcome here. Ignite our love for one another and for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And now our ushers will come forward to light the Pentecostal candle, symbolic of God's Holy Spirit with us and welcome with us. We light this candle as a sign of God's Spirit at work in the world. May it shine to brighten our spirits, and may the light of God shining through us brighten the world. Amen. And now let us sing together our hymn 386. Hymn 386, let us stand and sing together, O Thou Who Camest From Above. Hymn 386. we affirm our faith. Together, in our bulletin, the affirmation. Let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below.
And now, as we remain standing, we sing the first two verses of Breathe on Me, Breath of God. Then we will go into, when you pull your bulletin, we will go into the responsive prayer, which is the energies of the Spirit of God. You will see that in the bulletin. And then we will end our prayer time with the last verses of Breathe on Me, Breath of God. So let's remain standing for the first two verses, and we will have a seat for our prayer time. 300. Let us pray.
This is a responsive prayer this morning, and the congregation will respond in the bold print. When we come face to face with the challenge of self-giving, when we are asked to go the extra mile, to take the risk of reaching out to another, to offer forgiveness to the heart that rejects us.
When our world seems bleak, when we walk with sadness written on our soul, when we have days in which everything goes wrong, Spirit of God,
stir the energy of your joy within us.
When anxiety and concern take over our spirit, when the restlessness or boredom holds sway over us, when our world cries out in distress and turmoil,
Spirit of God, deepen in us the energy of your peace. On those days when we hurry too much, during those times when our anger flares because our agendas aren't met, when we stop giving people our understanding and acceptance,
when someone needs a simple gesture of thoughtfulness, when a look of love is all another asks from us, when a good word could take the sting out of the gossip of foes,
Spirit of God,
as we face the shadow of our inner world, or peer into the darkness of our outer world, as we struggle to believe in our own gifts and blessings, Spirit of God,
in those difficult times when fear threatens to drown our trust in you, during those experiences of growth when we are tempted to doubt all the ways we have known you,
when harshness or abruptness dominates our moods, when we feel challenged by the power of another, when we use the things of this good earth,
Spirit of God, bless us with the energy of your gentleness.
And now, let us prayerfully sing verses 3 and 4 of hymn 300, Breathe on Me, Breath of God. And now our offertory hymn, number 554, O Come and Dwell in Me. We will remain seated as the offering is collected, and we will stand for the final verse. And now, Mrs. Ann Lever, with the dedication of the offering.
Today, as we experience the grace and the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and as we dedicate our own offerings, let us first reflect on the words from 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verses 4 to 7. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit gives them. There are different ways of serving, but the same Lord is served. There are different abilities to perform service, but the same God gives ability to all for their particular service. The Spirit's presence is shown in each person for the good of all. Let us pray. God bless us as we receive and as we give. God bless our gifts and multiply them for your kingdom through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of God's word, the first scripture reading by Mrs. Charlotte Albury. And this will be followed by a solo by our Mr. Allison Underwood.
First lesson is taken from Joel 2:28-32. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions. And also upon the servants and upon the handmaids in those days will I pour out my spirit. And I will shew wonders into the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall come to be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord came. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord had said, and in the remnant whom the Lord shall call. Here ends the reading of his holy word.
Thank you, Lyra, for that introduction. This morning, you're all going to help me to sing, especially the chorus. It starts out with the chorus, and you just follow in your boat, and I'll relate to you when to sing. I'd like for you to sing along. It's printed in the bulletin. So we start the chorus first, and then I sing a little, then you join me for the rest of the chorus. I think it goes about three times. I hope this song brings us closer together in spirit and in truth, that we might follow Jesus in accordance to his holy will. Circle of love is unending, standing the test of all time, binding our spirits together, creating one heart in one mind.
One in the Holy Spirit, joined together in grace, marching onward to Zion. Sharing
Take my hand in your hand, stand together with me. We'll celebrate salvation in perfect harmony.
For introducing us to that beautiful, catchy tune. We are one in the Holy Spirit, joined together in praise. Thank you once again, Allison. And now for our second scripture reading, a reading from the Word of God, read by Miss Sandra Major.
The second scripture lesson is taken from St. John chapter 14. verses 16 to 18 and St. John chapter 16 verses 5 through 7. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth not him, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. And verse 16, 5 to 7. But now I go my way to him that sent me. And none of you asketh me, whither goest thou? But because I have said these things unto you, sorrow hath filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. This is the word of the Lord.
And now, as we continue our service, I'd like to ask our dear Barry forward to assist us as we lift our voices in song, as we prepare our hearts to receive the message by Reverend Lightbourne. We will lift our voices and sing and invite the presence of the Holy Spirit into this place. Our Comforter, come Holy Spirit, sweet, sweet Spirit. Please, it's in your booklet. Let us sing together the chorus medley. And we'll start with "The Comforter Has Come."
Oh, spread the tidings round, wherever man is found, wherever. Thank you.
Thank you so very much for your lovely singing this morning as we have gathered for worship on this Sunday, which we celebrate and commemorate as Pentecost Sunday. And as always, we would like to express our profound gratitude to all of those individuals who have ministered to us in various ways during this worship experience this morning. We are indeed grateful to you for your ministry to us. You may have heard that the annual business conference was held this past Wednesday and Thursday, virtually at St. Michael's, and I would like to give you a brief report on those individuals, especially the principal persons who were elected to serve for the next 3 years. Elected as the new president was the Reverend James Neely, the current minister in charge at the Global Village Methodist Church. The vice president elected was Mr. Donald Cash, who serves as the dean of CLET. The general secretary that was elected was Miss Eleanor Campbell. And finally, the treasurer that was elected was Mr. Ricardo Pierce. So those were the principals elected to serve for the next 3 years. And two of our members from Ebenezer were also selected to serve as assistant secretary and treasurer, my dear wife, Dr. Linda Lightbourne, and Mrs. Miriam Vargas, to serve as assistant treasurer. So we extend our heartiest congratulations to those individuals. And they solicit your prayers as they seek to lead the conference for the next 3 years. The Holy Spirit, the Father's gift to us. I would also like to remind you that there will be no prayer Bible study this coming Tuesday. We resume the first Tuesday in June. And during the month of June, we want to begin a confirmation class. So if you are interested in signing up for that confirmation class, please call the church office with your name and contact information. Let us pray together. Father, we are grateful this morning for the opportunity we have had to assemble ourselves in this place that has been set aside as a place of worship. We thank you for all of those who have led us in various ways. And we pray, Lord, that you will receive our sacrifices of praise and worship to the glory of your name, offered to you through the merits of your Son. May now the words of my mouth and the thoughts of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, through Jesus, who is our rock and redeemer. Amen. The Holy Spirit, the Father's gift to us. A children's class was being taught the Apostles' Creed, and each child was given a point of doctrine to learn and repeat. The first child began, "I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth." The second child said, "I believe in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son." And after he completed his sentence, there was a period of anxious silence. Finally, a child piped up and said, "Teacher, the boy who believes in the Holy Spirit isn't here this morning." Well, as I look over the congregation, We're just about all here this morning. And as Methodists, we do believe in the Holy Spirit, as we affirm every week in our creed. Following the resurrection and prior to his ascension, Christ spoke with his disciples about his return to the Heavenly Father. But he reminded them that his departure from them, though it might be painful and bring feelings of grief, it will open the way for the coming of the Holy Spirit, the Father's gift to them and to us. And so he said to them in John 14 and verse 16, "And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter, that he will be with you forever. I have been with you for 3.5 years, in one place, at one time. But this one will be everywhere, and in and with you all the time." Now, the word that Christ uses here for another is a very interesting and insightful word. It's the word in the original text, allos, A-L-L-O-S, which literally means another but the same, different but the same. "This one," says Jesus, "who will be given by the Father is of the same essence, nature, and being as I am." Notice also how Jesus describes or speaks about the Holy Spirit. He is a person, a divine person. The Holy Spirit is not an it, an energy, a force, an emotion, a phantom, or some spooky sensation, but rather the third person of the divine Trinity, the one who became the resident God here on earth. "And this one bequeathed by the Father to us," says Christ, "will fulfill certain ministries in the lives of God's people when he is sent by the Father. And so in our remaining moments together, I want to focus on a few of those titles, terms, given by Jesus concerning the Holy Spirit and the Spirit's ministry to us. First of all, he reminds us that the Holy Spirit is our comforter. The Holy Spirit is our comforter. Jesus tells us in John 14, verses 16 through 18, "And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter," literally another helper, "that he may be with you, not for a short period of time, but forever. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you through the Holy Spirit." And chapter 16, verse 7 tells us, "But I tell you the truth, it is good for you that I'm going away. Unless I go away, the Comforter will not come to you. But if I go, I will send to you the Comforter." Jesus describes the Holy Spirit here as the Parakletos, from which we get our English word paraclete. And the word literally means one called alongside, one who goes alongside for protection, counsel, and encouragement, one who bears witness for, or one who helps another. It's the picture of a friend who goes alongside to help a person in distress, or a command, a call to help a discouraged and dispirited army, or a lawyer called to help a defendant who needs his case pleaded. As comforter and helper, Jesus says the Holy Spirit comes alongside of us when we are pained, distressed, crushed, saddened, overwhelmed, discouraged, grieved, fatigued, and broken. He comes alongside of us and enfolds us in those loving, caring, and compassionate individual arms. The Reverend Dr. R.A. Torrey, the former noted minister of the Moody Church in the city of Chicago, tells the story of losing his 9-year-old daughter. He said the grief, the loss, the sorrow, and the bereavement they felt were unbearable at times. One rainy afternoon, as he walked from the men's to the church, to his office, he found himself standing in the middle of the street, weeping, mourning as the rain came down and soaked his body. He recounts that afternoon, as he stood there and wept out of the grief that he was still feeling, it felt like someone came and wrapped their arms around him as he was bathed in tears. Strangely, he said, when I looked around, there was no one nearby. And this is what he wrote. In that moment, I realized it was the divine comforter, embracing me in my grief, my sorrow, and my loss. And it was the turning point for me on that journey of sorrow. He concluded, the comforter came, and I felt his embrace. Ah, my friends, in the midst of all that we may be facing and going through, we are in the loving embrace of the comforter, the helper, the one who goes alongside of us, the one who is our divine ally, traveling this journey of faith with us. The Holy Spirit, says Jesus, is our comforter. Secondly, Jesus reminds us the Holy Spirit is our revealer. The Holy Spirit is the great revealer, the great revelator, communicator of God's written word and Christ, God's living word. The scriptures that we have came by and through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. 2 Timothy 3 and verse 16 tells us that all scripture was breathed out by God through the Holy Spirit. In 2 Peter 1 and verse 21, for the scripture did not have its origin in the will of mankind, but holy men spoke from God as they were carried along, as they were moved along by the Holy Spirit. And that's why we accept the scriptures as being the inspired word of God. Because it came from God through the Holy Spirit. And it is his word to us. And that word inspired and given by the Holy Spirit is still being revealed, still being opened up to us in the time and age in which we live. It is through the Holy Spirit that Christ, the Son, our Savior, is also made known to us. And just as Christ came to reveal or to make known to us the Father, so the Holy Spirit was given to reveal and make known Christ to us. And what we know of Christ is made known in Holy Scripture through the Holy Spirit. Next, of the Apostles, chapter 8, verses 26 through 36, you recall the account of the Ethiopian eunuch who had gone down to the city of Jerusalem to worship at the temple. And after having worshipped, he was returning to his native country of Ethiopia, a man of tremendous position and standing. And as he was riding along, he was reading from the prophecy of Isaiah, Isaiah chapter 53. But he couldn't understand or make sense of what he was reading. And so the Holy Spirit prompted Philip and instructed him to go and join this eunuch, which he did. And he joined them in his chariot. And he said to him, "Do you understand what you're reading?" He says, "No, how can I, when I have no one to explain it to me?" Of whom is the prophet speaking? Is he speaking of himself or of another? And Philip was able to explain to him of whom the prophet Isaiah had spoken. And as a result of the ministry of the Holy Spirit through Philip to that Ethiopian eunuch, he was able to come to a personal faith in Christ. The Holy Spirit was the revealer of His Word to us. Holy Spirit, truth divine, dawn upon this soul of mine, Word of God and inward light. Wake my spirit, clear my sight. Lord, thy word abideth and our footsteps guideth. Who its truth believeth, life and joy receiveth. So Jesus reminds us that the Holy Spirit, the gift of the Father, is our comforter. The one who not only indwells us, but who goes alongside of us. He is the revealer of God's word to us. The revealer of who Christ is to us. Thirdly, Jesus reminds us that the Holy Spirit is our teacher. Our teacher. The image or concept of a teacher is one with which we're all familiar. We've all had teachers. They are persons who instruct and impart information to us. They show us how to do things and accomplish tasks. They assist us in the process of learning. Perhaps some of our teachers have been outstanding teachers. Teachers that we remember to this day because of the impact that they made on our lives. Others perhaps were not so good. Some were stern and frightening. And there are some perhaps we couldn't please. No matter how hard we tried, we never got that A that we felt we deserved to get. But my friends, not so with the divine teacher. He is gentle, understanding, and knows what we need and how to reach us. Speaking of the Holy Spirit, Jesus tells us in John 14 and verse 16, "The Comforter, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name," notice, "will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance the things which I have said to you." And there were times when that was actually the case, when the disciples were hauled before the Sanhedrin and the courts. As they gave their defense, the Holy Spirit came and gave them that which they needed to say. He is our teacher. We're reminded here that we don't necessarily have to go to a college or to a university or to a seminary in order to understand and interpret the scriptures. The Holy Spirit, the one who inspired and communicated the scriptures, will aid us in our understanding, in our grasp of scripture. And all he desires is for us to have open hearts, open Bibles, open minds, a little time and a willingness to know and to understand. As Jesus said in John 17, verse 17, if anyone wills to do my will, he or she will know of the doctrine, whether it is of God. And so as our teacher, we pray, open my eyes that I may see. Glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Place in my hands the wonderful key that shall unclasp and set me free. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my eyes, illumine me, Spirit divine. Holy Spirit, open thou thy blessed book we read. Shine upon its holy pages with the light we need. And it was Charles Wesley who wrote, come, Holy Spirit, for moved by thee, the prophets wrote and spoke. Unlock the truth, thyself the key. Unseal the sacred book. Jesus reminds us the gift of the Father, the Holy Spirit, is our comforter. He's our revealer. He's our teacher, but notice, fourthly, the Holy Spirit, says Christ, is our partner in prayer. Our partner in prayer. The Holy Spirit is described as our intercessor, our prayer partner, the one who helps us in our prayers. Yes, we have Jesus, our mediator, who is at the right hand of the Father. But yet, there is also the Holy Spirit who intercedes for us. Have you ever been so burdened, so pained, so overwhelmed by some situation in life? And you tried to language your words in prayer, but you just could not. There are moments when we all perhaps feel like that. When perhaps because of physical weakness, some physical illness, we find ourselves lying on a bed, unable to really speak our prayers. We can only groan or sigh or mutter. In those moments, Paul tells us that the Holy Spirit, he takes our groans, our sighs, our mutterings, our tears, and he carries them into the presence of our mediator Christ, our intercessor. And he then carries them to the Heavenly Father. He tells us in Romans 8, in the same way, the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we do not know how we ought to pray at times. But the Holy Spirit himself pleads for us, intercedes for us with groans that words cannot express. And Christ, who knows the mind of the Spirit, takes our prayers to the Father. So the Holy Spirit becomes our heavenly prayer partner. What an encouragement and a blessing that is this morning, to know that we have one who resides in us, but who also prays with us and prays for us and leads us into the presence of the Father in prayer. When we cannot pray as we desire, the Holy Spirit, our prayer partner, is there to assist us. Holy Spirit, prompt us when we kneel to pray. Nearer come and teach us when we ought to say. And finally, and very quickly, Jesus reminds us that the Holy Spirit is our enabler. He helps us to live life. Following the birth of the early Christian church, as they began to multiply and to grow, and as they began to scatter out, persecution broke out against that early Christian church. Many were taken and thrown into prison. And they were told not to preach, not to witness in the name of the resurrected Lord. And as they were brought before the Sanhedrin, as I noted earlier, to give their defense, they were empowered and enabled by the Holy Spirit to give their defense and to live and to minister and to suffer victoriously in spite of all that they were experiencing. And that same Spirit is with us this day on this Pentecost Sunday in 2022 to give us the strength, the grace, and the power, and the help that we need as we live life and as we journey with Christ through faith. I will not leave you as orphans, but I will send to you the Holy Spirit, and He will abide with you forever. Let us pray. Father, we have looked hurriedly at the gift that you've given to us through the person of your Holy Spirit. We thank you for the realization that He is always with us, that He enables us to serve and to do those things which we're called upon to accomplish and to do. And even, Lord, for life itself, when we face its challenges, its mountains, its valleys, and we feel that our human strength is unable to carry us on, and we find ourselves asking why, and we find ourselves groping at times for some certainty in life, we thank you that your Spirit is with us, and He enables us to continue to live life. Be with us now as we depart from this, your house of worship, but not from your presence, we pray. Amen.
Amen. And just before the singing of the final hymn, permit me to say thank you to everyone who participated in the service. First of all, the youth liturgical dance group, Gia and the group, thank you. It is always such a blessing when young people contribute to the service. We thank you, and we thank parents for their support. To our organists, today, Dr. Lightborn, to our musicians, thank you for using your gift to just bring joy to our service. We do not take it for granted in any way, shape, or form. Mrs. Ann Lever, thank you for your dedication of offering, and thank you to the decorating committee. Just a special thank you. It takes time and effort. A special thank you to them for contributing to the service in such a way. The scripture readings, Mrs. Charlotte Aubrey and Mrs. Sandra Major, we thank you. And the solo, Allison Underwood, thank you so much, Allison. We appreciate you so much. And of course, Barry, we thank you for leading the prayer chorus along with us this morning, and for the role that you play in the music ministry of our church. And for all of those who are behind the scenes, right down to the security is on the outside, escorting us across the street, to the caretakers, we give thanks. We are thankful and we are grateful for all of those persons. And for everyone else who has worked behind the scenes to make sure that our services run smoothly, we give you thanks. We truly thank. And finally, we thank each and every one of you for being obedient to the mandate of the Holy Spirit, for the mandate, God's mandate, to not forsake the assembly of the brethren. So thank you for being here this morning. And thank you for all of you who are online. Thank you for staying with us. And Rev, of course, thank you for such a wonderful message. And now we stand and we sing our final hymn for today, our closing hymn, 387, 387. Let us sing lustily. My God, I know I feel thee mine. Hymn 387, our closing hymn.
And we repeat together our mission statement: to worship God joyfully, offer Christ faithfully, promote growth hopefully, serve others lovingly. Please receive the benediction. We go giving thanks for the gift of the Spirit of God. We go lit from within. By the great love of Christ, we go in peace, and God goes with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, and amen.